This was found on Saturday in the attic of my late uncle, and it came home. It sat in the car for a few hours. It's now been sitting indoors in the dry for 24 hours, so hopefully all the condensation and anything like that will have gone. And you can see from the box, it's a Philips video writer. I've not really investigated it other than actually in the confines of the loft space, seeing if it actually was what it claims to be. So doing all of this one-handed, holding the phone in the other to record this for your benefit, hopefully. Let's see what we've got. Okay, so first of all, we've got a monitor stand, it looks like. I'll put that to one side down there. And now everything is clearly in its original polystyrene. I can see the ribbon cable here of a printer head. There's a keyboard down there. So I'm going to pause you for a second, get all of this out of the box, and see how it all appears once it's out. Okay, so it's out of the box. I've stood it on top of the stand. The whole thing stands on that stand. It's not a separate monitor. This appears to be a monitor. So it's all in one. The keyboard has a socket on it, which appears to be rather like a phone connector. But that plugs in here. Let's do that. I can line it up properly, one-handed. Can't see what I'm doing. Okay, that's in. Also in the bottom of the box, we have some 3.5-inch floppy disks. Let's have a look at what they are. Double wrapped by the looks of it. That should have protected it from any moisture. Again, I'll just pause you because I can't do this one-handed. Okay, so there's four discs. A demo program, a video writer, all Philips branded. Philips video writer, what does this say? Focus please. Dictionary and storage diskette. Diskette, that's a lovely old fashioned word, isn't it? And then a couple of generic discs which my uncle has presumably stored some of his own stuff on. We'll maybe get to that later if the rest of it appears to work. Also in the box is the instruction manual. Looks like a receipt for some repair work. £160 for the fact that it's stopped in the middle of a print by the looks of it. I'm not too concerned about showing you the name and the address. My uncle is deceased and that address is very old anyway. Stopped in the middle of print. So it had a replacement capacitor and a clutch and an output transistor. So that was a repair done. And the date for that was 1997. What else have we got? Again, I'll pause you for a sec just to get these bits out because they need unfolding. Okay, they all appear to be sales receipts for accessories, new ribbon cartridges. Predominantly, I was hoping we might get the original sales invoice to get an idea of how old the machine is. But anyway, there's a Dixon's receipt dated 1993. Something else dated 98, 96. So it appears my uncle got a fair good use out of this. 95 on this one. So we won't worry about the paperwork, as I was hoping I might have the original sales invoice, but never mind. Right. Well, it's got a plug on it. I've got power available here. So let's plug it in, see what happens. Okay. There's an on-off switch here. I can hear a fan starting up. And it's powered up. Philips video writer. Please insert a video writer disc. Well, let's try the demo program disc. It says, I don't know if we can focus on this. Please insert disc with the cutaway corner at the top front. Be sure to push disc all the way into unit until eject button snaps out. Clearly, using floppy disks was not common practice before, so it's telling you right from square one how to use it, and here we go. I can hear the disk drive clicking away. We've got an adjustable brightness on the screen here, which seems to work perfectly. I can hear the disk turning. But there is a warning. I don't know if you can see it. That says no disk. So maybe this disk has suffered over time. Let's forget that one then. Oh, now that's awkward. It's reluctant to release the disk and it's still clicking away. I may have to power it down and try and get that out another way. Ah! That appears to be trying to work. I'm sorry about the focus on the phone. But we've got a complete menu here. Menu 1, create new document. So if I do that, create new document, hit enter. Type the number of your choice, which I have. It's not recognizing that. So then press do to work on document. Press delete. Let's press do to work on document. If I can find do. There's do. Ah, here, creating document. Document creator. The cursor's asking me to enter a document name. So to all intents and purposes, this appears to be working properly, and I'm not going to go any further. I'm not going to attempt to print anything because I think you've seen enough. I think over to you. I'm going to stick this on eBay as working up to the point of what you've seen in the video, and I won't do any further than this, but it looks like we've probably got a going concern. I wouldn't for one moment expect that the print will be capable of printing because it will have dried up ages ago, I'm sure. But I think you can still get bits for these online. So I'm going to say goodbye to you for, thank you for watching this. If you've followed the eBay link, then this form is part of the description of what you're buying. If you bid for this, and I'm not going to take things any further than this, because I think now it's over to you. Thank you very much. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.